Types and properties of soil. What soil is made up of? Cooperate with one of your classmates to get 3 different colored samples of soils: yellow, dark, and gray. With a hand lens, try to identify the different particles each sample of soil is made up of. Compare the shape and color of these particles with those present in the picture in front of you. Which kind of particles is found in each type of soil? The question now is, are there different types of soil? The answer is yes. Soil is of many types. Types of soil. Soil can be classified into 3 different types according to the kind of particles as follows: clay soil, sand soil, and silt soil. Clay soil is composed mainly of clay and silt particles and a small amount of sand particles and humus. Sand soil is composed mainly of sand particles, a small amount of clay, and silt particles. It rarely contains humus. Silt soil is composed of a mixture of gravels, sand, clay, and silt. It contains great amounts of humus. Comparing the properties of different types of soil. Activity 1. The color of soil. Let's carry out this activity to know the different colors of the 3 types of soil. Cooperate with your classmates in examining 3 samples of soils: sand soil, clay soil, and silt soil. Examine each sample. What is its distinguishing color? The color of sand soil is yellow. The color of clay soil is dark. The color of silt soil is gray. Activity 2. The size of particles. To know the size of particles of each type of soil, let's carry out this activity. Take small equal samples of 3 different types of soil. Spread each of these samples on a piece of white paper. Examine the size of particles of each of these types of soil by using a magnifying lens. What is the type of soil that has the largest particles? What is the type of soil that has the smallest particles? What is the type of soil that contains a mixture of large and small particles? The soil which had the largest particles is the sand soil. The soil which has the smallest particles is the clay soil. The soil which has a mixture of small and large particles is the silt soil. Activity 3. Soil compactness. To know the degree of compactness of each type of soil, let's carry out this activity. Put 3 equal samples of sand, clay, and silt soils separately in 3 similar dishes. Add to each soil sample an equal amount of water and let them expose to the sun and air until they get dried completely. Crush each sample of them by your fingers. Which type of soil has strong compactness? Which type of soil has weak compactness? Which type of soil has medium compactness? The type of soil which has strong compactness is the clay soil. The type of soil which has weak compactness is the sand soil. The type of soil which has medium compactness is the silt soil. Activity 4. Aeration and water absorption. To know the degree of aeration and water absorption of each type of soil, let's carry out this activity. Get 3 glass tubes opened at both sides. Cover one end of each tube tightly with a piece of cloth, as shown in the figure. Put in the 3 tubes equal amounts of sand, clay, and silt soils separately. Immerse the 3 covered ends of the 3 tubes at equal depths in a basin containing water. Does water level rise through the soil inside the 3 tubes? Very good. Yes, it rises. Does the rising of water result from the presence of air spaces within the soil? Very good. Conclusion. Sand soil has large air spaces within it, so it is well aerated. Silt soil has medium air spaces within it, so its aeration is medium. Clay soil has small air spaces within it, so it is poorly aerated. Activity 5. Drainage of water. To know the degree of water drainage of each type of soil, let's carry out this activity. Bring 3 similar funnels and put a small piece of cotton in each to close their internal holes. Put 3 equal samples of sand, clay, and silt soils in the 3 funnels. Put a graduated cylinder under each funnel. Pour 3 equal amounts of water in each of the 3 funnels. Which type of soil drains water quickly? Which type of soil drains water slowly? Which type of soil is rather slow in draining water? What is the relation between draining water and the aeration of soil? The type of soil that drains water quickly is the sand soil. The type of soil that drains water slowly is the clay soil. The type of soil that is rather slow in draining water is the silt soil. The relation between draining water and the aeration of soil is that when the soil is highly aerated, it drains water faster, and vice versa. Activity 6. Soil fertility. Take 3 graduated cylinders with a wide opening. Fill one of them with sand soil, the second with clay soil, and the third with silt soil. Note, fill each of them just to the middle. Fill each cylinder with water and cover it tightly. Shake each cylinder strongly, then put it on a table and leave it for 15 minutes. What do you observe? The sand soil has a little amount of humus. The clay soil has a reasonable amount of humus. The silt soil has a great amount of humus. Conclusion. The sand soil is poorly fertile. The clay soil is rather fertile. The silt soil is highly fertile. From the previous activities, we can conclude the properties of the 3 types of soil. Number 1. Color. The color of sand soil is yellow. That of clay soil is dark, and that of silt soil is gray. Number 2. Size of particles. The particles of sand soil are large. The particles of clay soil are small, whereas those of silt soil are a mixture of large and small particles. Choose true or false. The particles of silt soil are very small and are gray in color. Very good. It's false. Number 3, compactness. Sand soil is non-compacted, loose. Clay soil is highly compacted, hard. Whereas silt soil has medium compactness. Number 4, drainage of water. Water drains so quickly in sand soil. It drains so slowly in clay soil, whereas silt soil drains very poorly. So, clay soil retains more water than silt soil, which in turn retains more water than sand soil. Choose the right answer. Space soil has medium particles and medium compactness. Sand soil, silt soil, or clay soil. Very good. Silt soil has medium particles and medium compactness. Choose true or false. Clay soil is dark in color and drains water quickly. Very good. It's false. Number 5. Aeration. Sand soil is well aerated, clay soil is poorly aerated, while silt soil has medium aeration. Number 6. Fertility. The fertility of soil depends on the amount of humus. So, sand soil has low fertility, poor in humus. Clay soil is rather fertile, and silt soil is highly fertile. Choose the correct answer. Clay soil is space, rather fertile, highly fertile, or poorly fertile. Very good. Clay soil is rather fertile. Choose true or false. Sand soil is well aerated. Very good. It's true. A comparison between different types of soil. The following table explains the different properties of the types of soil. Properties: sand soil, clay soil, silt soil. Composition: sand soil is composed of sand particles. Clay soil is composed of clay and silt particles. Silt soil is composed of mixture of gravels, clay, sand, silt, and humus. Color: the color of sand soil is yellow. The color of clay soil is dark. The color of silt soil is gray. Size of particles: the particles of sand soil are large. The particles of clay soil are small. The particles of silt soil are medium. Aeration: the aeration of sand soil is good. The aeration of clay soil is poor. The aeration of silt soil is medium. Compactness: the compactness of sand soil is weak. The compactness of clay soil is strong. The compactness of silt soil is medium. Water absorption: water absorption of sand soil is low. Water absorption of clay soil is high. Water absorption of silt soil is medium. Drainage of water: drainage of water in sand soil is fast, in clay soil is slow, and in silt soil is medium. Retaining water: sand soil retains less amount of water. Clay soil retains more amount of water. And silt soil retains medium amount of water. Fertility: sand soil is less fertile. Clay soil is rather fertile, whereas silt soil is highly fertile. The relation between soil and living organisms. Number one, soil helps plants to fix to the ground. Number two, soil provides plants with nutrients and water. Number three, soil is a suitable medium for the activities of some living organisms. After you have studied the types of soil, let's ask this question. Is there a relationship between the cultivated plants and the type of soil? To answer this question, let's study the soil and plants. Plants are affected by the type of soil in which they grow. So, each type of soil suits a certain kind of plants. Number one, sand soil is suitable for plants that produce tubers, such as potatoes, sweet potatoes, cactus, and plants which give fruits beneath soil surface, such as peanut plants. Number two, clay soil is suitable for cotton plants, rice, sugar cane, wheat, and many vegetables. Number three, silt soil is suitable for many plants such as strawberries, lemons, pomegranates, and oranges. Choose true or false. Cactus is planted in sand soil. Very good. It's true. Silt soil is suitable for cultivating rice plant. Very good. It's false.